Hi everyone, my name is Carson O, HMM here on YouTube, or Carson O. We do History Mystery Mondays. If you're new here, thank you for clicking on this video. So if this is the first time you're ever seeing me, History Mystery Monday is anything historical, people, places, things, you know, events, whatever, anything that's happened in history that I feel like I want to talk about and bring more light to that maybe others don't know about. I'll talk about anything mysterious that I find. Maybe we'll dabble into a little bit of true crime later on. Don't worry. Paranormal, if there are. I have a few videos that I've already done for paranormal type things. Anything really I feel like talking about that could be under the category of history or mystery, and we do it on Mondays. So if you're interested in that, please hit the like button on this video, hit the subscribe, hit the bell notification so you'll be notified when I post on Mondays. And if you're interested in any of the other topics that I talked about, go check my channel out. I have a whole bunch of videos that you might be interested in and want to learn more about the history or the background of these certain topics that maybe you never knew. So today we are talking about Dame Agatha Christie. She is the murder mystery detective novel queen. She is the reason why we have them. And if you've ever seen Death on the Nile, if you've ever seen Murder on the Orient Express, she was the one who wrote those novels. And now they have become movies. So if you want to know more about her life, just keep watching this video. I will have a multi-part series on this, so this is just the first part. So let's jump into Miss Agatha Christie's life. Agatha Mary Clarissa Miller was born September 15th, 1890, making her a Virgo. If you're interested in astrology like I am and want to know people's signs, well, Miss Agatha Christie was a Virgo, so I just wanted to include that just for those people like me. She was born into a wealthy upper middle class family of Frederick Alva Miller and Clarissa Margaret Miller Bomer. But Clarissa went by the nickname Clara, which most of the time while I'm talking about her mother, Clarissa, I'll be saying Clara because that was her nickname that she more prominently went by. When Fred's father passed away in 1869, he left his daughter-in-law, Clara, £2,000, which is about £281,353, or in US dollars, it is $345,374. In 1881, they put that money towards a house, buying a villa in Torquay, a seaside town in Devon, England. And they named it Ashfield. This is where they had their third and last child, being Agatha. She has a sister named Margaret, but Margaret went by Mage. She was 12 at the time, and her brother Louis, who went by Monty, and he was 11 years old. Agatha's childhood was known to be a very happy one at that. Since her siblings were so much older than her, there weren't that many children that were actually Agatha's age in the town. So, since that was a thing, Agatha spent most of her time instead playing by herself with the pets of the family and her imaginary friends, who she made since she was very lonely. She did eventually make friends with girls in the town, and she had said that this was one of the highlights of her existence. According to Agatha, Claire, her mom, believed she shouldn't even learn to read until she was 8 years old. But because Agatha was curious and didn't want to listen to her mom, well, Agatha was like, I'm gonna start learning how to read at 4 years old, because screw you, mom.
Like, this is how Agatha was most of her life, and even being 4 years old, she was like this.
Maige, her sister, was sent to a boarding school, but Clara insisted that Agatha was to be homeschooled instead. She was taught by her parents and Maige on reading, math, or maths, as the English say, and writing. She also learned to play piano and mandolin as well. When she began to start reading, she was reading books from Mrs. Molesworth and Edith Nesbit. But once she got a little bit older, she started on books from Edward Lear, Charles Dickens, Lewis Carroll, Walter Scott, Anthony Hope, even Alexander Dumas. When Agatha was 10 years old, in 1901, she wrote her first ever poem called The Cowslip. During the same year, Fred, her father, his health was deteriorating due to what was believed as heart issues, which could had really been anything from a stroke to a heart attack, since it's 1901 and the medical health, you know, industry at that time was not as advanced as it is at this current time. And so they couldn't really say or figure out what exactly it was, but it could have been anything from, you know, a stroke or multiple strokes or even having a heart attack. But it was just heart issues as of from 1901. In November, he ended up passing away due to pneumonia and chronic kidney disease at the age of 55 years old. Agatha later was recounted saying that her dad's death at the age of 11 was marked as the end of her childhood. The family's finances started to worsen due to Fred's passing. Maige, she married in 1902 and moved to Chatham, Cheshire at the age of 24. Monty went overseas to serve in a British regiment at the age of 23. Agatha then was left behind with her mother Clara at Ashfield Still. Later in the year, Agatha was sent to attend Miss Geyer's girls' school in the town, but she found it difficult to adjust in the atmosphere of disciplinary styles. 3 years later, in 1905, Clara sent Agatha to Paris, where she attended a few different boarding schools, which they called pensionnats at the time. They focused on her vocal training and continue her journey on playing the piano. Agatha learned she had a lack of talent and patience. She realized, well, she isn't gonna get into the opera and become an opera singer, as her vocals are not that good, is what she said. Or she was not going to become a concert pianist at the time at all, either. She thought she was just like mediocre and everything. So she was like, well, that just puts down my dreams. I'm not going to become one of those type of things. Through the years of 1907 and all the way to 1926, she began writing more and attempt to have her works published. At the age of 18, she wrote her first short story called The House of Beauty, which was about 6,000 words about madness and dreams while in bed recovering from an illness. Others were called The Call of Wings, The Little Lonely God, and more. She submitted them under a pseudonym like Mac Miller, Sydney West, and Nathaniel Miller, due to the issue that we all know back in the day that if you're a woman, more likely they would not publish you. So that's why she had to use pseudonyms. She began working on her first novel called Snow Upon the Desert and submitted it under another pseudonym as Monosyllable. Six publishers contacted her to decline the submission. Clara, her mother, suggested that Agatha should ask the advice of a successful author and family friend, Eden Philpotts, who he was also a neighbor to them as well. He introduced her to his own literary agent named Hughes Macy, but he also rejected the novels, but suggested Agatha should write another novel. So I'm going to stop right here, at least, just because I'm going to do about three parts. And this is just kind of the beginning of her life into, you know, early adulthood. And then the next part we will talk about her early adulthood up until an event that we will get more into. If you know anything about Agatha Christie and her life, you probably can guess what I am hinting at. So if you are interested in learning anything about that event and more of Agatha Christie's life and when she wrote certain novels and everything like that, please come watch the rest of the video. I will end up putting this in a series, so you can just watch them all together on my channel. Like I said at the beginning, if you are interested in watching any more types of these, I have another three-part series for Marie Antoinette. I'll have more coming throughout the years for this channel. And yeah, so if you're interested in anything like that, please, if you want me to cover a specific thing, let me know down below and I will look into it and probably cover it for you and give you more information about it. So just let me know. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. And don't forget to hit subscribe. Don't forget to hit the bell. Come back every Monday. Go follow me on Instagram and TikTok now. Instagram is COS on YT, but TikTok is Carson O HMM. So you can come search me just like you do over on YouTube. I'm starting to post now to get more people's eyes on my channel, at least I hope, fingers crossed. But yeah, so if you're interested in that, please go follow, give some thumbs up, give some love. And I hope to see you guys in the next part. But until then, I will see you. Bye.